Hello everyone, my name is Raylazor and welcome back to Ring of Fates. After a long delay, we're back and ready to take on the Crystal Temple. I've filled up all our Magicite and Potion pouches, so we'll be good to go. And throughout this area, I'll be trying to conserve as many of my healing items as possible, and I would recommend you do the same. And the big reason is that at the final boss, there is a very difficult way of grabbing healing items without restarting, and you'll see what I mean near the end of this video, I guess. Anyways, let's just go up this nice little staircase here, and we want to head off to the left side first. There we go. And the objective here is to take out all four enemies. What I want to do is take care of the lizard man right here first, and I do this by hugging the invisible wall by the stairwell. Hopefully I don't get hit by that spell. There we go. Alright, let's just move in here and get our charge attack in. And the reason being is that there are four enemies on this area that are really well condensed together, so I'd like to avoid tripping them all off at once if at all possible. So there's our first Sahagin. And there's a second one sitting in the water as well. So how do we lure this guy out? Can you hop up here or something? I'm okay with you actually jumping for once, so you should totally do that. Or you can just keep spitting bubbles at me, sure. Alright, you're not just gonna... Let's just get to business. Okay. Right into the water I go, huh? This is gonna be a bit of a problem. Oh, Lord. This is not good. Please, leave me alone. Oh, I am not ready to get tag-teamed by two Sahagins already. This is what I mean. This is what I mean when you have too many monsters condensed together. Two is too many already. Get out of here. Go away. Alright, that's one. You two. Nah. And we should be good now. There we go. And the last monster is a lizard man hanging out by his lonesome just over here. So let's take care of you. And with that, we should be able to spawn a magic platform. There we go. Right there. Yeah, we want to ride that thing, but before we do that, we can grab a chest over here with some nice scrolls. And we don't really need to heal. I actually did a pretty good job with that, despite getting smashed in by a bunch of spells. Alright, let's get on this platform here. And before you run straight into the entrance to the X area, you want to turn to your right to get a few scrolls and special items and stuff like that. Let's see here, what do we get this time? Got a thing that's sitting on the bottom, okay. And double hop right here. White marble, alright, cool. And before you move up ahead, you want to charge up another cat because to your right is a chimera. Now there is also a Sahagin sitting in the water behind it, but that is an optional enemy to fight. You don't actually have to do it to progress. So I'd rather engage in a one-on-one fight here real quick, despite him getting all the attacks off on me already. Bit of a nuisance, aren't ya? Okay. Yeah, can you just... There we go. Alright, now you're dead. Fantastic. As you can see, this activates a switch. We'll do that after. What I want to do first is, one, heal so I don't die immediately. And two, take care of that Sahagin in the back, so... That missed. Fantastic. Okay. Let's try this again. Really? Am I just bad at this death perception thing? Oh, it's because you're underwater. Oh, what a jerk. Okay, well, let's just... face the right way. Come on, Sokia. There we go. Get a few hits in there. Stun, and we are good to go. Alright. Nothing really good here. Old Hellish Iron isn't too bad. Let's flip the big switch using the small switch, and this will activate more switches. Ah, yes. Alright, fantastic. Let's ride this thing back up. There we go. And we'll go all the way around. Avoid all these enemies, since we've already taken care of them. And over in this room is a scorpion boss. The two bad things about this guy right here is that it has an increased pool of health to help scale with, you know, fighting at the final area. As well as the fact that it doesn't have a health bar, so you have no clue what's happening. This thing's also the bane of my existence because it's caused me a few too many game overs. Considering how strong these things are nowadays, getting hit by one drill attack will usually insta-kill me. Not a big fan of that, but there we go, no problemo. Let's use the cure magicite it gave us. And move on to the next area. Now we've got plenty of switches and things here that we could easily hop up to, being our superior Selkie class, but We're just going to avoid that for now. We'll be able to get back here soon enough, and I'll explain the purpose of that room. In the meantime, we have two enemies here now, and that's going to be one Flangoop and one Chimera up ahead, so let's take care of them. There you go, got a measly 500 gil for that. We don't need your trash money now. Actually, I'd love all of your trash money. Alright. Go up here, take care of you. Gonna get smashed in close range. You can usually avoid the little balls that it spits out by hanging right behind it, but that's not exactly the most successful thing. There you go. That's a difficult time curving usually. And with that, we take care of the Chimera. You don't want to break these barrels just yet unless you're a Selkie. They contain two offensive Magicites each. Then you'll hop up here to activate a switch. And the switch will create this little gateway that opens up, and you can access that now. So I'm going to back all the way out of this thing, back to the stairwell we were at earlier. And we're going to take the right side entrance this time. So let's go do that. And of course, the Scorpion boss respawns every single time. So it's a really big nuisance if you don't know how to plan your timing out correctly. Was that words? Close enough. There is a different method where you only have to encounter the Scorpion boss one time, but you're gonna have to be a Selkie for that, and we'll be showing that off in a little speedrunny portion, I guess. Yeah. Alright, in the meantime, let's just take care of this Scorpion so we can move on ahead. Having stun attacked is fantastic on these monsters. You gotta do a lot more damage, and you got usually an extra free hit or two in on them. So it's pretty good. Alright, come on. Alright, this is... I'm just gonna play it low just to be safe, because we got the attack power and the speed, so we don't have to worry too much for that. And I guess I will use the Cure Magicite again. What's my level up at? Never mind, let's just hang on to it. We're pretty close to a level up. Alright, let's just leave this whole shindig here. See ya later. Please don't hurt me. And we'll go to the right side of the stairwell now. And this will give us a one-way path straight to that gateway we just opened up. Now, you want to take the bottom platform first from here, just so you can activate the switch that lets you move and move on ahead. There we go. And over here are a bunch of chests that we can access at. Kind of hard for anyone but Selkies to get at, but as you can see, even when you manage to hit them and hop all the way across, you can still fall off. So, with that being said, let's just grab these scrolls then. Celestial weapon, okay. Don't really care about this stuff now. Instead, you can actually hop right over here and just do a quick double jump. I'll use this in our speedrunny thing. In the meantime, I'm too lazy to walk all the way around, so there we go. Hit our little checkpoint rope in case you ever need that. And we'll be able to move right on around. If you're anything but a Selkie or very unconfident with your jumping, unlike me, you can just hit that switch and go back and not fall off and embarrass yourself in the viewership in the public of many, many people. This room is poisoned and there are plenty of enemies here. You need to kill all of them in order to unlock that special room that's down there. So we'll be able to get at that now. In the meantime, let's just break these barrels and get all the healing items out and ready. Gonna use one right away. And why not? We'll use an elixir while we're at it. Since we got one available. And I might as well heal up our clear magicites. Aren't I leveling up? What am I doing? Okay, well, we're not doing that. Okay. Sorry about that. There's a few skeletons hanging down there. Usually they spawn up top, but they get tripped up pretty easily. You want to avoid the edges of this giant platform here because they have a tendency of hurting really badly. So let's just take care of this Chimera first. The biggest threat here, really, since the others can easily be avoided by their spells. And this guy will usually stay up here. Hello, please don't hit me with your balls. Alright, let's back up real quickly because I can hear the spells going off like crazy right now. There we go, got our level up, fantastic. Alright, now for the hard part. Because usually, the platform has a tendency of blocking off the skeletons so you can't see where you're going. A little bit of a pain. I would recommend using your charge attacks just so these little fights here aren't too long, since they can get a little bit annoying after a while. There we go. Is that skeleton still up there? It was. All right. Well, I don't know if that hit it or not, but I'm just gonna wait for it to come by, even if this means losing a lot of our health. Really? Come on, step into the light, my friend. Okay, well, I've just gotta move a little bit further back. You're getting a little too close to my me zone. Alright, come on. There we go. That's one more down, and let's take care of the last one now. Alright, there we go. Yep, move away once again. Very risky considering these skeletons do a lot of damage, and you're constantly being poisoned, so you can easily die very quickly in this room, so play very cautiously here. And with that, we get to unlock our lovely little gate here. Let's take a look what's going on there. And it leads you to an absolutely useless room, the Scorpion Room. Now, this entire little, like, platform thingy that's going on up here is meant for people playing in story mode. Since monsters like the Scorpion boss don't respawn, and you can leave and enter without all the little, like, puzzles and stuff resetting, you could use this as a checkpoint to get more supplies. Unfortunately for us in multiplayer, that's completely useless, so let's head on back. The good news is that we have plenty of barrels right here containing healing items, so we can access them right away. Let's grab that clear. What? Raise Magicite, there we go. Okay. I guess I'll use a potion. Just because I don't want to try to reach for those cure Magicites hanging off on the bottom. And we'll use an elixir while we're at it. There we go. And I'll just use this. Can't be wasteful here. There we go, a whole 20 SP, not too bad. Fall right off anyways. Okay, back up we go. Okay, this is not exactly going according to plan. Please, no more pain. Alright, there we go. Two lizard men hanging out here, nothing too much to worry about. It's a little bit of a tight, strange looking zone, so just be careful about that. Alright, pretty good hit there actually. Alright, don't think we'll be able to need to use any more SP here. Actually, just backpedal a little bit quickly. I have a tendency of getting hit quite a bit like that, actually. This is not too good. It's okay. We'll just stay back here for a little bit. Grab that. Hello. Don't hit me. Thank you. Alright. Whoa, okay. And let's grab our cure Magicite. There we go. And take care of the lizard. Come on. You have a lot more health than I expected. There we go. Alright. Let's switch to our Thunder Magicites, and this is another little bit of bad news for Selkies. If you didn't grind or like power level throughout the game, you won't be able to cast two ring locks, so you have to hold one and wait for the other to activate. This can get a little bit annoying with the timing thing, but what else can you do? Let's move on ahead, and this leads us to one of the biggest rooms in the area, with these little switches which change the colors of the walls and the positions of them. And that's the main gimmick of this area. What you want to do is throw a block up here, a block to the left, and make sure you save one block for this switch right here, since you're going to need to activate a platform. And you'll probably want this thing to step on, and that does not make sense. Alright. There we go. Step on this. And if you're having a bit of trouble missing the rope, you want to hang on to the little tip of this little circle here. The edge of this, right in front of the pedal. And this will usually land you on your rope where you want to be. There we go. Now, the door in the center of the mini-map is a special safe room area, so what I want to do is try to tightrope walk across, and this will either fail miserably or succeed fantastically. We'll have to see. Let's break this barrel and grab another barrel hanging up over here. There we go. Nothing down here, but I'll show you it anyways. There we go. And the way we want to progress is the last doorway, of course. Alright. And I missed immediately. Fantastically failed. Alright. Well, on our way of walking back, you want to activate and open up this wall here. And this thing is vital to completing this area, so make sure you remember to do that. Let's hit the switch, go back around, and I guess I'm going to have to try this again because I want to get into that safe room. And I frankly don't know how to access it in any other way. You know, sometimes you play the game incorrectly, and that's the only way you know how to play. I mean, what else do you expect? There's like two thingies here. How annoying, I just fell off again. Oh boy, okay. On the bright side, I'm a ranged character, so it's pretty easy to just flip these switches. If you're playing someone with melee, this is probably the most painful room for you, aside from rooms with like actual enemies. We'll have to figure that out later. There we go. The best way to judge tightrope walking would probably be to just look at the shadows on the ground. Please don't knock that thing. There we go. Alright, well, on the bright side, I can just, there we go. Alright, just walk straight across, hit that, left and down arrow, or that up and right arrow, just at the same pace. There we go. Well, I fell off again, but the good news is that we reactivated the door, so it doesn't matter anymore. One more try. The good news is that I won't have to access that stupid area when I'm doing the, like, little speed run for this thing, so that's good, at least. In the meantime, I can flop as much as I want. Alright. Now, this room's also a little bit special since it's usually meant for story mode, so to say. And if you go in here, we're gonna have to show a little bit of secrets. One, there's a lot of stuff for Lotis here if you ever want them. Two, the upwards area is blocked off because this is something you see in story mode, I believe. So, that's something to keep in mind. Now, we look at the minimap we are sitting in. The center room with three doorways outwards, alright? If you head to the right, you'll end up in this room, which is basically a training room. And somehow, this teleports you to the left of that room we were just in, okay? If we head to the right again, we end up back in the center room, okay? So what if we go left? If we go left from the center room, well, what do you expect? We end up in the left. So what you have to do is, whenever you're at this little center area here, it doesn't matter which doorway you go into. If you go into one of the doorways, you end up in the training room. Going to the right takes you back to the center room, and going to the left, regardless of which positioning you're at, takes you to the safe room. Fantastic. And this lets us access a Moogle and get a commemorative stamp. There we go. Now let's head on back. And we actually have something to do in the training room. The good news is that you don't have to worry too much about using your healing items because you can just run back to the safe room if you need to. Now there's four enemies here, two skeletons and two lizard men. So just, oh, we're gonna activate all of them at once. Oh, we activated three somehow. That's fine. I'll go ahead and use my charge attacks now since I don't have to worry too much about this and that. I'll just send that over there since I don't want to get too close to him. Alright, let's prepare another charge attack before we move in for the kill. There we go. Alright, that's one more killed. And I think I'll just back up real quick. I have 400 SP for a reason, and one of those reasons is not to get stunned by you, but sure. Alright, come on. Recover this stuff real quick. There we go. Alright, now you're dead. Fantastic. Where's that fourth one? There you are. You're late to the party, mister. Just take care of you real quick. There we go. One hit. Wait for you to hit me. You can spin around all day. Alright, there we go. Easy peasy. Killing them all doesn't activate anything in the room, but I'm gonna stand on this tile right here, right between this second and third tile, and start stacking stuff for yourself. Now, depends on how much you need to stack, depending on what class you are playing, obviously. I usually go for 5 or something. Evidently, the fifth one is a bit annoying to deal with. Don't worry, you'll be able to get them back if you need to. Here, we'll just... Alright, you just put that right there. There we go. Hop up here, and I'm gonna do a quick double jump. It's a lot more annoying if you're playing any other class. These barrels all contain lovely scrolls for you to use. And as you can tell, this area is meant for story mode, when you have four classes, four people to play as. Or multiplayer with four people. Unfortunately for us, we don't have friends. Well, I don't have friends. So, there we go. Got our scrolls. Let's head back and go back on the track to progress. And we'll prepare our raised magicite since we're going to be revealing a few more enemies. There we go. Go over here and we have two skeletons to take care of. So, let's activate one real quick. Stay away. And try to do as much damage to you as fast as possible. There we go. Got a level up too. Not too bad. Alright, now let's take care of the second skeleton. Now, each of the skeletons will drop two blizzard magicites and two fire magicites. What you need to activate this door. Before we do that though, let's get at this chest so we can break it right away. And look for the switch, there it is. Hit the switch, grab something, and hit it again. The bad news here is that if you're playing any other class but a ranged class, this might be a little bit more complicated for you since you actually have to time when you hit it. The good news for me is that I don't care. Yeah, being a Selkie is great. Oh. Hello? Oh, nothing's not- okay, well, let's try that again. I guess I talked over it? I'm not too sure. Alright, let's listen on in here, folks. There we go. Alright, let's grab these Magicites before they disappear. Oh, okay, cool. See you later, pal. But we're missing out on one Blizzard Magicite, I guess. Not too bad. We are running low on Raised Magicites, but that's okay. What you want to do in this room is, one, there's plenty of turtles back there. Let's break the barrels right away and grab whatever we need to. Because this room is about to get very, very cluttered, so... What you want to do is, like, put the items as far away as possible and grab what you need. So, I'm just gonna avoid those guys for a little bit and grab the stuff. There we go. And this is where your offensive Magicites come in handy as well. In a second, of course, we gotta... Let's hit this switch real quick, and this will activate a few targets for us to hit. Not turrets. There we go. Prepare a charge attack and get ready to mash in a bunch of skeleton turtle thingies that spin. They have a tendency of knocking you out of the room from the starting area. They will literally push you out of the room if you don't position yourself carefully, so that's something to be wary about. And now that we've taken care of a few of the skeleton turtles, we now have two skeletons that will actually show up. And that's not even the final wave, so don't get your hopes up. We really need to hide right now. There we go. Okay. Fantastic. Let me get at that real quick, thank you. Okay. Yeah, get that extra hit on me, pal. You're not gonna be living for very long. There we go. Alright, well, we got two raised Magicites now, just enough for two skeletons, hopefully. Alright, you and you. Listen, on this room, you can use as many resources as you want. Frankly, I am having a little bit of trouble dealing with these guys. It's not even helpful that it's tiered. You have like a bunch of different levels of areas to fight here, which makes it even worse. Since it just means you're just on three little small areas, it doesn't help at all. You can't shoot upwards. Alright. Well, let's take care of the final skeleton. Hello, you hurt a lot. Okay, well, we're just gonna hang back here, use a healing item or two. Don't mind me. Alright, back up we go. Hello, don't hit me again. And there we go. Well, that's one more down, and I guess the flying gloops are out now, so we'll take care of you. And alright, this is where our offensive Magicites come in handy, and that's because you can actually use Magicites to hit flans, because they are weak to magic. So you can just keep doing this. There we go. It's one of them down. Put one, and one more. There we go. Stand to a little bit to the left of the center on this platform here, and a key will drop on your head. Pick it up, toss it in here, and that's why I unlocked the doorway. There we go. Let's grab all this flan. Yeah. Oh, I just noticed the item is called flan goop, and they're not actually flan gloops. They're just flans. Well, it's okay. Close enough. They're still goopy to me. I'm gonna stand this back one rather than the one in the front, which I used to do for some reason. Wait for the camera to pan properly, and what you want to do is jump and then simultaneously hit the up, left arrow, and the attack button. And this should get you a perfect hit every time. There we go. Activates two candles, which you need to time properly, so keep that in mind. And you probably want to throw this block down right away in case you mess up, so you can get back up here. There we go. Now let's switch over to our fire Magicites. Prepare an attack here. Hop over. Prepare another attack, and wait. I like standing on top of the candle so I can actually see the little target. So I'm ready with a little bit of visual and audio confirmation. There we go. Let's slide down here. We don't really need this thing, but we can't get at it. Let's instead just hop onto these platforms here and move over to our second safe point. Never mind, this is a poisoned area. Boy oh boy. Alright, now I'm gonna kill these guys in a different order than normal. And that's because you can actually swing to the left right away and take care of this flan here. And then prepare charge attack, and going backwards, you can take care of a lizard man back here. And these are the only two enemies you need to actually kill in this area. Hopefully it doesn't kill me first of all. So let's prepare our cure magicites and heal up. But there you go, there's the key. And we'll go back and kill all of the skeleton turtle things. So, no worries. Let's activate the key first though. And avoid all of you. Alright, put that there. Grab the cherry. Move on over here. Alright. Now that we got rid of the poison by hitting that switch, let's take care of the rest of these guys. The health draining thing is a little bit annoying when you're dealing with a bunch of enemies and a bunch of tight corridors, so it's not usually a fun time. There we go. And now let's take care of you as well. Come on. Almost there. Anytime now. There we go. Got a level up as well. That's fantastic. Alright. And let's take care of the lizard. There's still plenty of things here to kill though, so don't worry, everything's packed neat and nicely together. The good news is that this is nearly the end of our adventure. Alright. Hop up here. Got flans on the sides. What I want to do is use my Thunder Magicites now, I suppose. Let's just trip you up. There we go. Alright, that's one. Put that right there for you. Just a little present. Shocking, isn't it? That was a bad pun. Didn't even make sense, really. Oh gosh, okay. That hurt. I was just sitting there gasping. Alright, heal up again. We're not doing too good on the whole healy thingy. We'll be fine though. Alright. It's mainly because I'm trying to juggle spells rather than use my SP. And that's because I want to conserve a little bit of my SP if possible. But then it comes to this guy, and then I just don't really care. So, let's just mash your face in, please. Never was a fan of lizards like you. Specifically the ones holding shields and axes. Alright, well, let's climb up on here, and this will lead us to our second safe zone now. Proper, there we go. Now, there's two ways you can go, and they both lead to the same place. I recommend going to the left, since you can get at a few goodies while you're at it. The right way is the fastest way, though, despite the fact that the corridor is really long. Let's go do a giant little puzzle minigame, so to say. Crawl up here. And this area is special, depending on what class you're playing, by the way, so keep that in mind. Let's hit the target, hop onto this platform, hit the switch while we're at it, and this will open the door up ahead. There we go. Hitting the switch will activate another target, or, well, another platform. And what you need to do now is to flip all of these switches. And it's going to be a pain sometimes because, well, you have plenty of things here that you can just get at. Usually you're supposed to ride on the platform. I find it easier to just, like, navigate here and, like, hit them manually, as you can see. It's a lot more annoying if you're playing as a Yuke, because I usually play as a Yuke and, boy oh boy, trying to cast fire or like sliding on a platform, it's no fun. Anyways, let's wait for this platform to return, and what we want to do is wait for it to sync up with that little moving platform over there. Rotating platform? Yeah, rotating. So we'll just hang here and wait on this. Anytime soon. Is it here yet? Usually you have to wait for two spins. There we go. Alright, and before you want to do anything, you want to let the camera pan down and just hop right here. Rotate on around and then hit the switch back here. And this is basically your checkpoint switch to get back if you ever need to. Wonderful. And now we can just avoid the two rotating platforms and wait for a platform to come up here. Now this one will actually drown you if you stand on it for too long, so we're gonna abandon ship as fast as possible. There we go, as you can see, it just drowns you. You will be guaranteed to drown here because you gotta hit the switch to activate a boulder. Now, usually I got stuck at this area, not really sure what I had to do. Needless to say, this thing's been in the game since the very beginning. You gotta push that boulder into the hole. So let's do that. There we go, knock that in, and this will create a chain reaction, or it'll just roll onto another switch. Fantastic. This will activate a key that we now need to put into the doorway that's up ahead. And then we'll be able to get at something else real quickly. We'll stand on these things and get back up or fail miserably because you apparently needed a double jump for that. What? Alright. Try this again. There we go. Maybe I just hit my head on the bottom of that platform. Alright, let's climb on over here. Grab this. And now we gotta wait for it to come back. There we go, there's the platform. And now we gotta wait for the key. So let's just hang here and just enjoy a little spinny dance. Yay! We're looking pretty decent on supplies right now. Our potions haven't been touched, nor our elixirs. And we'll probably be able to grab a few cure mag sites and clear mag sites in a bit, so nothing too much to worry about. And I'm gonna play this a little bit safer. There we go. And let's wait for that platform once more. Now you might be wondering what the reward is for doing all this compared to just going down a long corridor. And it's the fact that one, this door opens, so yay, we're done, we can leave now. And two, we activate a chest back here, and this thing obviously contains the permanent upgrades of this area. Now, if only I could take this rope back. I believe you're actually supposed to ride this platform and use your little checkpoint that you just activated. Now, the permanent upgrades in this area is definitely not worth it, considering how much time you waste for it. You can do it if you really want to. It's not too bad of a reward, but it's not a very efficient reward, so to say. You get a bunch of attack-based mag sites, raise pockets, and I guess a healing boost. Not too bad, but there are definitely better ways at getting that stuff. Let's move on ahead, and we'll spawn on the other end of the next area, so this is where you have to deal with two bats. Very annoying. They have a tendency of casting fire spells, which thunder spells, which stun you, so let's just kill them as fast as we can. There we go. One's down, and two's down. There we are. If we were to take the long hallway, we would end up on the opposite end of this map, where you can see another enemy is sitting at, so let's just hop on over there. Obviously, you usually ride the platform, but being Selkies with our superior jumping power, that won't be necessary. Now, I want to use my raise match site, so let's... Okay, this is what I get for taking the public transit. Alright, back up we go. Let's just wait for this. And please don't hit me with thunder. Lightning, actually. I blame the game calling it a thunder magic site. Alright, come on. There we go. And killing them all will activate a key for us. And this will lead us to the final room, so to say. So we are nearing the end of our journey, and somehow we have succeeded and managed to get max healing items. Wonderful job, brilliant. Applause for Raylazor, the number one, and Sokia for participating here as the person doing everything, the stunts woman. Alright, let's get that key in there. Apparently that thing rotates right in, and we hit our final and third checkpoint. Now this is where I'm going to do a little bit of annoying talking, and that's because if you weren't saving your healing items, the good news is that, one, you can leave right now, I believe. Yep, you can just leave, and I'll take you back to the previous room. I'm not gonna chance that, because bad things happen. And then the bad news here is there are four enemies. This lizard man, and another lizard man, and I believe two skeletons. So you'll be able to see them in a second, so let's just take care of these guys real quick. There we go, that's one. And he's the only guy to drop healing items. Two cure magicites, one clear magicite, and one raise magicite. Go over here, we got a skeleton. Oh, let's take care of you too now. There we go, and what do you drop? Items, alright. Let's rotate on over again. Alright, another lizard man. Let's take care of him. Maybe he'll drop more healing items. Here's a hint. He doesn't. Alright, more items. Okay, this last guy should surely have some items for us. Let's find out. Alright, let's cast a cure. And real quick, I'm just gonna grab this one right here since I don't want to waste this stuff. And we'll use this. That was actually a bad waste since we have a save point right there. Alright, let's take care of this last guy. Okay, that hurt. Really badly. Alright, well, let's just use a charge attack. What am I doing? Oh gosh, I'm just gonna game over at this rate. There we go. And he also drops items. Now, entering one of these little boss areas, so there's your first ring, which we're going into next, and these two other rings. Entering one of the rings means you can't go back. If you try to leave back into the black void, you end up at the main screen, because guess what? Screw you. So, if you weren't conserving your items, now is a great time to leave, restock them, and try to play a little bit more conservatively. With that being said, let's fight our first boss, to Chaspo. Now, most people usually can't get beyond him because he doesn't have a weak point with a red crystal, so to say. He's just a boss with a lot of health. As a Selkie, you want to first mash his face in with as many arrows as possible. So that's what we're going to do real quick. And hopefully we'll get a stun, which is great, which means we get to do a little bit more damage and stop him from whatever he's doing. Now, the main gimmick of Kuchaspo is that he's able to cast two clones of himself. And this is where the annoyance comes in. You want to do as much damage as possible before he does that. Otherwise, you're screwed like me, and you have to prepare a bunch of supercharge attacks. Now, what you want to do is prepare, stay moving, and once you see a weak point in him, cast a spell and move on ahead as fast as possible, because getting hit by three Kuchaspos is not a fun time. You can tell who's the real one by looking at the minimap. The boss one is the one with the little square icon. It's a little bit annoying when they're all close up. And this is also where your elixirs come in handy. Now, most people will use 100 SP for their supercharge attack. You can somehow conserve this if you have other abilities on your equipment that makes it so you use less SP. But overall, having a bunch of elixirs is also a fantastic alternative. And you just want to keep rotating out on this. Once you lose all your elixirs, unfortunately you're going to have to use your cure magicites, or clear magicites, which are a little bit slower, which means you're open to a little bit more danger, so that's something to keep in mind. If I wasn't screwing around hanging back there because I got hit, I would probably be able to get a few more hits on Kuchaspo, and I would be able to stun him if he was summoning his clones, and this would make it so I get to hit him a few more times, and that's very powerful. As a Selkie, if you do that, you might be able to basically kill him before he even casts his clones out. So that's something to keep in mind. This fight seems like it's slanted very well against Selkies, but that is definitely not the case if you use this method. Wait for him to fall down. Okay, sure. You can just do that to me. I'm just gonna run away before I get murdered. Bye! Please don't kill me. Alright. Let's heal up and recover all our SP. I'm going to stick to using potions since we're going to need the clear magicites for the next boss fight. Alright, let's prepare a few more charge attacks and hopefully I'll be able to get a decent amount of damage on him. I'm probably going to have to use my clear magicites at this rate considering I left quite a bit of his health bar out in open. But as you can see, you rarely get hit by this unless you're just stupid like me. Let's just wander away there. There we go. Prepare another attack. Move on around. Please don't kill me. I'm so close. Oh, okay. Get in there again. Go for a regular attack just because I want to spit in his face. I'll be able to do that once I beat him in and then go buy a bunch of weapons and stuff from him and then beat his face in again. Not a fan of you, Kuchaspo. You silly goose. Alright, there you go. Recover again. Not too bad though. You get more SP from using your clear magicite. I'm pretty sure that's just dependent on how much magic you have, what your magic stat is, so something to keep in mind. Yukes will have a fantastic time with clear magicites. You can just drop one down and use your tribal ability, and you're basically good to go for the rest of the fight. No, you aren't. Also, another good news is that since he constantly recasts his clones, you're able to just kill them pretty easily later on when they have low health. In my case, I prefer to just focus on him the entire time. And also, I am in a risky biz right now, so just get far, far away from me, please. There we go, got two more attacks. We should be able to beat Kuchaspo at this rate. There we go, alright. And he's down. And that's one of the, four bosses we have to fight. There you go, let's grab all these things here and move on ahead. I don't need to go away. Yeah! Alright, now, let's talk about that black void I mentioned. Now that we've activated our second magic circle for the boss, going back, you'll notice there's that black void. Don't step in that in multiplay! That's how you return to the main screen and makes it so you have to redo everything again. Not a fun time, I would not recommend it. Let's move on to the second boss. And the second boss is basically the Hierophant. So nothing too much to worry about. He's actually a relatively easy boss compared to Kuchasco, who was extremely aggressive. The best way to fight the Hierophant is to stay right behind him the entire time. He'll fire laser beams which can reach his head, so don't try to stand on top of him. And most of his attacks are forward only, like that laser beam, and his other laser beam which will knock you and then blind you. And you can break these crystals for a few supplies if you want. He's invulnerable, so there's no point, there we go, in attempting to hit him. And let's get back to the regular Shindig. After a while, he'll get really mad and throw his little ring head thingy. You'll see that in a second, hopefully. And it doesn't seem like he wants to show off his blinding attack, and it might be because I'm hugging up against him so easily. Oh, there we go, there it is. Yeah, you don't want to step on that. It blinds you. It makes it so you do less damage, I believe, even if you can see him. And this is where he starts throwing that thing. That thing cannot be dodged, so just try to hit him as many times as you can while you're at it, because now he's vulnerable. And this is where we get hit by this laser beam. Okay, it's fantastic. You want to make sure you check your status ailments so you're not, like, going to die or anything. There you go, let's avoid all that. Getting poisoned is also a real big pain, but it's alright. You can also break his wing thing if you want. I think it respawns. It really doesn't matter at this rate, since you should have done quite a bit of damage to him. And as you can see right there, for some reason you also get EXP from the crystals or something. So that's fine. Let's just keep working on this guy, and he should be dead anytime soon now. No wings, and since you chucked them, he's pretty vulnerable. Oh, Lord, what did you just do? Okay. Well, I've never seen that before. Hope you enjoy dying there, pal. You just chucked me off the map. Alright, well, that's new. Anyways, let's just grab these items here and move on to our third and, so to say, final boss. And grab that raised magic site just so I can have it. There we go. Alright, second one's down, and we're down to our last fight. I think I feel like killing a certain lizard man just for a free clear magic site. There we go. Yeah, die! You heinous monster. Yeah, alright. This is where you use those cure magic sites you've been saving. Right? Let's go. This is what happens when you take meth, kids. Now, this is the biggest annoyance. As a Selkie, you're unable to do enough damage to get rid of all the horns and, like, hit his little special crystal area. So the bad news is that you'll probably be doing this kind of damage throughout the entire fight. The good news is that the fight ends halfway through. What you want to do to avoid these annoying crystals is not to focus them, but rather use your piercing attacks in order to hit both the Hierophant simultaneously and the crystal. The biggest part of this fight is that you have to constantly do damage to the Hierophant. Prolonging this fight only increases your chance of dying, so I would highly recommend you try to hit the Hierophant as fast as you can. The good news is that crystals sometimes trip up their own spells and makes it so that they can't chase you. And sometimes you screw up and you get hit by a Thunder Magicite spell. Breaking them open, they contain a bunch of Magicites, I believe, and sometimes Dark Crystal. That stuff doesn't really matter at this point, you got a boss to fight. And his gravity attack will always do half damage and makes it so you can't jump. Avoid falling into that little nook at the bottom of this fighting field because that basically sends you to your death. Alright, let's get back up. And once again, try to just line up so we can hit both the crystal and the Hierophant simultaneously. And this will bring ease to you during your fight. He obviously respawns them, but the good news is that by doing so, you'll be able to make it so you have less attacks following you around, less spells, because you gotta stay on the move throughout this entire fight. Now, playing as a melee character, something like a Clavat, is probably a lot easier since you don't have to worry about stuff like that. When you're playing something like this, not so much. Alright. The good news is that we pretty much got rid of all the crystals at this point. Let's get rid of this last guy, because yeah, screw you. Just because. Alright, avoid that head attack, still get hit by it because there's a huge damage radius there. And let's just focus on doing as much damage before he respawns those crystals. It's better to cast a spell and then grab the Magicite rather than try to throw it in the middle of the battlefield. Don't bother trying to go for the crystal, you can try if you'd like, but it doesn't really matter. And here they come back. Alright, here we go. Back to our original thing. We got rid of one right away, which is pretty good. He respawns all four when this happens, so that's something to keep in mind. Is that a fifth one there? I don't know if he just casted the respawn or not. There might be five. I don't know. Listen, I hate this boss fight specifically. This isn't even the last one, but I hate it so much. Oh boy, I really, really need a heal right now. Okay, well, I managed to get that in time. And I managed to avoid the frost thing. Ah, God is by my side and I won't die tonight. Ah, okay. Well, remember, you can hit the crystals from either or, and you can hit the Hierophant, then the crystal, or the crystal first. I prefer hitting the crystal first so I know what I'm aiming at. The Hierophant, he's a big bulky guy, so I don't have to worry too much about that. And I just got stunned, so let's just keep this at. And as you can see, I've already prolonged the fight too long. I haven't been hitting him very much, so this isn't exactly the best run. The good news is that I haven't died yet, so that's still a plus. And a big contributor to the fact that you can't fight as fast is probably because of the crystals freezing or stunning you. Fire doesn't really matter since it barely interrupts you, but considering these guys have a very big fantasy for thunder and ice, can't say I'm a big fan of that. Alright, just get hit by that thing again. Alright, let's focus more on the Hierophant because I've been being pretty stupid right now with how I've been playing. The meteor attack seems pretty easy considering how slow it is, but if you get hit by two simultaneous meteors, you're dead, guaranteed. That stuff does huge amounts of damage and you can probably only get hit once before your game over is inevitable. So let's just focus on doing more damage to you. We're doing pretty good there, we're almost at that halfway point. And I consider this guy the hardest boss. Yeah, I've mentioned this already. Alright, there we go. And now he'll switch over to his final phase where he makes the fight easier because why not? Instead of sitting on a crummy little rock, you can now fight in space. Make sure you rely on your minimap to avoid the attacks he casts. You want to usually run to the closest corner to you or the corner farthest away from the boss. But he's pretty standard. He can now use his attacks from his second boss fight, where we were sitting on the top of that tower when he, you know, threw me. Another thing he can do is cast a blind spell, the laser beam, stuff like that. And he has one special attack for you once you manage to break off all the little thorns hanging around his little rotating disc here, because he didn't work on his leg day. He clearly skipped it. Just hiding his embarrassment right now in a strange almondy toppy thingy. I don't know what's wrong with him. You can step up on top, to try to hit him a little bit more and get more damage out on him. I wouldn't recommend it because he might accidentally slide off and run into his spell attacks. You can if you want, if you're feeling a little bit risky for extra damage, but you'll be able to see what he casts soon enough. Hopefully he actually casts it before this fight ends, because we pretty much have won. Or we can just get smashed in by a giant blue claw, so let's not count him out of the fight just yet. Now it looks like he's casting an attack, which is a giant laser beam you can't see. Getting hit by that thing is an instant kill, so that's a terrible idea to get hit by that damn thing. There we go, there it is, in its full glory. This is what I mean when you might accidentally run into his spell attack. I've played it plenty where I stand on top of the floaty thingies, rotating thingies, and I just run straight into the beam and die, and it's just a bad time. You sometimes might also accidentally get hit by the beam through his back. The hitboxes are wonky, so let's not try to do that. We've already done plenty of damage by just hanging out behind him, so we will be just fine. Make sure you use as many Cure Magicites as possible during this fight whenever you need them, because this is literally the end. This is the last fight. Alright, just run away from you. I have so far managed to get hit by pretty much every single spell he's thrown at me, haven't I? Oh boy, alright, let's run to the opposite end. Don't try to rely on these like stupid glowy things that tell you it's the end of the map. Just use the mini map. Get a little blue dot and a little square. It makes it a lot easier. There we go. Got a few more points of damage in there. We're doing great. Alright. And we've managed to review his crystal again, which doesn't really matter. Well, we can keep trying at this. There we go. Almost there. Come on, start shouting and do your stupid thingy. Also, when you completely finish off his health bar, make sure you have a Magicite ready or else you might screw up. If you're playing with friends because you have friends somehow, make sure they also have Magicites, and you'll see why in a second. Well, by the time I kill him. Okay, let's just move back before I get hit by a laser beam. There we go. And we are almost there. There we go. All right. Now, there will be one magic ring for every single party member you have. What you want to do is cast a magicite to it, and it will automatically lock in. With that, we defeat the final boss.
Except for the extra boss is still alive.
There we go. It's over. Until I have to do the speedrunny thingy. Alright, let's grab all of this stuff, and what should I do now? I think I will... we'll just walk straight through, why not? Whatever. And we end up on the credit screen. How lovely. Alright, this has been a journey. It's not the end of the journey, mind you. We still got our victory lap to run on around and stuff. Probably leave the screen, do a quest, talk to a certain Moogle, talk to the townsfolk, talk to a certain annoying fellow with a mask that delayed this video by a week, albeit this video is late by like 2 months or something. We'll wear some pirate gear, hopefully, or something. And yeah, stuff like that, I suppose. This has been quite the journey. If you're wondering why this video is out so late, if you're like following this in real time, well, I already released a video on that, so you can check that on that stuff. Overall, I'm a big fan of the series and managed to let me show off my creative prowess by making a nice little overlay and like try things out like showing off all the item stats, which is something I'll never do ever again. That is so much editing and such a waste of time in my opinion, but hey, that's there. Still gotta give the regular Crystal Chronicles a go, I suppose. Tons of things for me to do, mainly to finish things up and whatnot. Probably the most worried about is hard mode and harder mode, which I won't be showing on screen, but there are plenty of things that we can check out there, which hopefully I'll be able to get to. That is something that I'm still on the ropes about whether to record or not. I want to do it, but at the same time, I'm basically just trying to unlock costumes, and that basically requires me to play through the game 2 more times. And believe me, I have played through this game a few too many times for any sane person, so that's a thing. Hello, are the credits ending anytime soon? Good job, Pierre Gaultier! Yeah, whoever you just did, I forgot your role already. That's nice. Yeah, Yoichi Wada, good job, corporative executive. Square Enix, fantastic job. Don't really understand why there's 2 red squares in your logo, but I guess that's a thing. We did it. Yeah. Just stay on the screen a little bit too awkward. Okay. Alright, let's head on over to Rebena Te Ra. Welcome to Rebena Te Ra. The town is peaceful and bustling as always, and that's your key to saying, this town is complete. Yeehaw. Fantastic. Let's look around. What do we have here? The air seems much cleaner these days. I can see Raylazor as clear as a crystal. Could it be because the monsters are less populous than before? Oh, okay. Well, once again, reference to Crystal Chronicles where everything is screwed up, we're living in a perfect universe. Hey sis, the numbers of monsters is way down. It's safe enough to go exploring, don't you think?
No.
Won't be reckless or stupid. Some safe and simple games like hide and seek close by.
No means no.
Last of all, why can't sis understand the pull, the draw, the romance of adventure? When I am older, as the gods are my witnesses, I will become an exemplary adventurer like you. Maybe it's a phase or a growth spurt or something, but we can't seem to stay put or stay still.
Save adventuring for when you're grown. While you're young, do only what the young can do. We realize youth's magnificence only after we've lost it.
Youth is wasted on the young.
Alright. Jaded as ever, I suppose. What are you up to?
Nope, you don't matter. See you later, generic guard. Having too many monsters here was a real drag, but now that they're almost gone, I'm bored. It's hard to strike a balance when you're talking monsters. Now that life's settled back to normal, I feel like it's time for me to set off in search of Mr. Right. I have to, because let's face it, none of the guys in this town are nearly as good looking as I am. Okay, see you later. You don't want to say anything new since you're busy talking about hair or something. What are you up to here? There's Saloti here. There he is. I forgot to tell you about the crab I saw when I was crossing a really wide river on my way back to town. This crab was huge. I'm talking gargantuan. Ooh, just think of all the crab cakes I could make with it. That's a reference to something we'll be doing soon enough. Rumor has it that you can hear screams coming from the castle at night. You think maybe they have ghosts? What a nightmare. I'd never sleep. That's also something we'll be doing soon. The monster population may have gone down, but you won't see me going on any trips. Not a chance. From now on, I vacation at home. Now that the monsters seem to be going down, I'm thinking about my next vacation. How does this one sound? It's Worlds Unseen, Capture the Soul, Raylazor / Shadowlands Tour. Alright, well, you people, you'll never understand the problem of trying to kill every single monster in an area. Gee whiz. Hello there, adventurer. You're looking chipper as usual. Oh, I have to tell you, I had a dream the other day about the moon turning a deep red. The bluish moon grew increasingly red right before my eyes. I was very upset at the time. Huh, as if the moon can turn red all of a sudden. Crazy stuff like that only happens in dreams. What could have brought on that strange dream? I mean, the moon has always been blue, hasn't it? Well, I'm sure it has, my friend. Let's just walk past these guys, and go hop up here. There we go. Let's talk to our first shop of the day. And we'll be able to buy an attack boost, which is lovely since we gotta go back in into the fire soon enough. Get some defense, which is also nice. Fire pocket, sure, I'll take that. What else do we have here? Blizzard and clear pockets and something this and that. Trust me, I'm just seeing stars that I managed to beat this all on camera without the recording failing on me. But it's not over yet. The video is not over yet. I forgot the voices for these guys. Let's try this again. Nap time, guard duty. Who knew I'd enjoy being worked like a dog? Okay, go get out of here. Ah, nothing beats basking in the sun all day. Comedy's overrated. Okay, why are you? Why? Okay, just jiggle over here. Okay, just fall right off. Come on. Let me talk to animals. I have a spiritual connection with them. Hello.
Glad all the humans are back. I'm eating like a king again.
I can't burp on. Actually, I can, but listen, that's for another day. Do you say anything new? No, you don't. Cool. Let's get to business then. Let's fill up on all our magicite pouches and our potions. There we go. Wow, we are quite low on money actually. Oh, we'll be able to check this in a second. There we go. I'm also curious what's going on in the armory first, so we won't be checking on Kuchaspo just yet, mainly because I haven't thought of a voice for him yet. I'll probably just go with my generic, because that's always good. There we go. Alright, to the armory. What do you have here? We have any new bows? Probably one or two. We have a bravery bow. That's nice. Head armor. Great mithril helm. Don't really care. Pretty sure I've already checked on all of this stuff too. Caravan clothes. I believe caravan clothes is basically the hard mode version of the travel clothes. When you're playing hard mode and harder mode, all of the items are renamed with increased stat points, but they're the exact same thing, so not exactly necessary. Yeah, it seems like that's that.
All right.
Okay.
Pardon me, I've just had a most strenuous workout that I didn't move all that much. Ah, how sad. A stinging reminder I'm not young anymore. Or maybe fall from that height would be too much for anyone. Oops, just mumbling to myself again. Hazards of age, don't mind me. So what will it be today? Don't forget, our motto is relax and leave the customizing to us.
Well, glad you still hold a day job, Kuchaspo. I want to check on what I have real quick. So let's buy stuff first because I want to buy things. Alright, sort things by weapons first. What do we have here? Nothing that seems valuable here. Anything here at all? No? Bunch of old clothes aside it? Okay, that's fine too. We have these. We might actually need these specs, so we'll just buy some of these just in case. Other specs, Garuda specs. Beast specs? Yeah, sure, we'll get those too, just in case. We're not covering all the items, mind you, but yeah, it's always good to have these just in case. Don't really remember what these marbles are, so I'm just going to avoid them. I guess I'll get the black and white marbles because I know for a fact that you sometimes need them. And nothing refined yet. Onyx, which is not my biggest thing. We'll get it. We'll get it. Why not? There we go. Alright, how about materials? We have petite sapphires, emeralds, onyx. Oh boy. Oh, my favorite. Isn't that right? Okay. Is there nothing else here? Doesn't seem like it. Okay, I want to see if I can craft a certain item first. If not, we're going to have to do things in a little bit of a wrong order, so to say. So the strongman weapon, the dark weapon, the celestial weapon. I usually prefer using the dark weapon or the strongman weapon. Celestial weapon contains magic. I think the strongman weapon straight up does more damage than the dark weapon, but the dark weapon has a few special equipped bonuses on it. Alright, so let's see here. Sailing headwear requires one mithril silk. Okay, that's one. And where's that pirate thing? Because we can actually finally wear the pirate thing now after so long. Alright, and we need two more mithril silk apparently. Do I have two mithril silk? I can make miracle cloth. Alright, so that's one. Oh, I can make two miracle cloth. Fantastic, let's do that. Alrighty, let's make one. I think miracle cloth is supposed to be mithril cloth. I'm not sure. Or mithril silk. Let's find out here, shall we? Yep, that's mithril silk. Fantastic. We can dress like a pirate now. Oh boy. I've been waiting for this since a few months ago. Alright, here we go. Buccaneer suit. That's our first one. Oh boy. Alright, can we refine some onyxes then? Listen, I'll submit, okay? I'll make onyxes. Just give me like two. I'd love three, actually. Three would be great, but I reckon you're not gonna give me three. Should I save one? I might save one for the attack, like a weapon. Something to keep in mind. What's the Braid of Time real quick? I'm gonna have to check this. I think I need one of these, actually. So, yeah, we'll probably make one of those as well. Alright, let's get back to business. Plenty of things for us to make. Plenty of things that I'll probably have to show off screen. Or on screen, off screen, so to say. Let's put an amethyst on you. Actually, no, you're a suit. Let's put an onyx on you. Alright, there we go. What do we get? Pirate outfit with health absorb defense, which means if we get hit, we get health back. We got tribal secrets, which isn't too bad. And the pirate suit is considered the best because it provides the most attack damage, usually. Don't know why we're lacking out on that right now, but usually you'll be able to get a straight 4 attack bonus there. So these items are pretty darn good. Alright, and let's get our pirate hat. Sailing headwear, there we go. And we'll put an ruby, a petite ruby on it. There we go, pirate hat. And we got attack boost on that, which is a lot better. There we go, 20 points of attack, pretty darn solid. There we go, we're a pirate now. Alright, let's work on that weapon. I'm gonna go for the strongman weapon since it's it looks like it's supposed to be a pure upgrade, so we'll put an onyx on that. Pure statistic upgrade, and we're gonna get a bravery bull with... Jeez, that's gross. No! Oh, I'd rather make... I'm gonna try making something else then. Screw that. Ugh. Yeah, let's put a petite ruby. This is probably leagues better too. Yeah, we got a attack bonus here. Look at that. Yeah, we're not... Actually, I don't even want this either. Why am I making all these things on screen? That is a good question. Should I try to see... Yeah, I'll check on my orbs real quick. First of all, I want to try to make that, Braid of Time. There we go. This thing might be worth it. Put an amethyst on that. Petite. And... Fast Charge. Okay, that's something I wanted. Yeah, I'll take it. Can I make another one, though? I cannot. Alright, well, Let's see if we can make some hellish specs. Yes, we can make one more so we can try making one more dark weapon. Listen, we're pirates. Pirates are technically dark creatures, usually, so to say. At least that's what stats usually tell you. Dark orb, that's what I'm trying to make, not specs. Alright, is there a dark orb thing here? Specs, black marble. I need sulfur dust for that. Well, that is where my hellish specs come in, which I don't have, so, wow, screw that. Alright, we're done with that. Alright, let's take a look. We even got an eye patch, it's amazing. Alright, let's take a look. Yes, this is the culmination of our being, the pirate inside us. I don't know, I think it's neat having a pirate hat and whatnot. You can evidently tell what it's all based off of, like, the hat is supposed to be the tiara, except reskinned, so to say, more solid looking. Great. Well, if that is the case, we're not going to do a quest today then, because we gotta save that for later. So let's move on down here, and I guess I've talked to all of the townsfolk. Is it time to do our speedrunny? The speedrunny thingy, the thing I've been worrying all about? I guess it is. Alright, to the Crystal Temple, let's do our speedrunny. The good news with this one is that since a lot of the areas in the Crystal Temple don't require you to kill the monsters, we can skip through a large portion of that. Unfortunately, the portions which mandate you to kill enemies, like the Scorpion area, they drain time quite a bit. So, that's something to keep in mind, but something to keep in mind as well is that we can screw all of these enemies and hop right up here. Let's prepare a charge attack because once again, we only need to kill the Chimera. Okay, you're just gonna cast a breath thing on me? Cool. I'm just gonna get smashed a little bit. As you can see, we got a little bit of health from that. I won't wait for the blindness to go away first, if at all possible. There we go. I have an eye patch. Let's just switch over. That's the reason why they had eye patches. There we go. I'm gonna stand right on top of this so we can activate the switch. Now, when you activate the big switch, watch the mini-map because it will actually activate so we can actually start moving. And you'll see as this happens, I can actually leave the area in the middle of the cutscene. So that's a little way to shave off a little bit of time. And let's move on ahead, shall we? There we go, and now we have to fight the mandatory scorpion boss. Not too much to worry about, actually. Considering we just beat, like, God and then God Elite, I'm not too concerned about a little scorpion boss here. That being said, I'm not too big a fan of stepping on it now, so maybe we can just prepare a charge attack for that. There we go. Got a little bit more damage in there. Please die. Feels like we've nearly killed it. Okay, come on. Oh god, it hit me. Thank goodness I got saved by something. Die. Die. There we go. I was a little bit worried it was going to attack me, but we're still okay. Let's grab the Cure Magicite. Heal up. It's a little bit slower, but that's fine. Move on over here, and this is what I was talking about, how you only had to fight the scorpion boss one time. Because after you activate that switch, you don't actually have to ever go to the right side of that little winding staircase, since you've already activated the switch we need. Don't try to jump up though, because you usually won't make it, and that means you'll fall down. Just wait over here, there we go. Up top again. Hop, skip, and a jump on over. Can avoid all these enemies in the poison area because that was to unlock an optional area which was useless. Straight through we go, and I don't even need to kill these lizards actually, they can just stay back there. Let us work on taking care of these Magicite pillars, there we go. Come on. There we go, alright. I believe this leads us to this room, yes it does, great. Don't really need to activate that stuff, we can just run straight through if you feel like it. And I certainly feel like it. Now, I don't know if this is faster or not. Some people feel it's faster, some people feel it's slower. It doesn't really matter to me. Let's skip all you guys once again. Prepare our attacks. And now we wait. Oh, am I gonna be able to see the thing too? How lovely. There we go. What a fantastic day for me. Great. Now this is the bad part, because I gotta get a key. Alright, step on you, activate those things. I could try to run back and double hop up and do all sorts of strange things, but I'm not going to. Because that seems like it's going to waste more time. And I don't feel like experimenting today. Considering I just killed God. Guys, I killed God. It was a bad God, but I killed God. Not too big a fan of doing anything else right now. I'd rather just sit at home with a giant box of ice cream or something. I've done my fair share. I'd like to think I saved the world a good, like, 3 times in that final fight. There you go. Prepared the skeletons. Let's do a little bit more damage here. Gonna get hit by poison. How annoying. Well, then let's just kill these guys as fast as possible. There's one. And there's two. Please. There we go. Alright. Switch to my Healy. Plenty of items all over the floor, which makes it hard for me to attack that enemy, like I said earlier. Why you want to clear out all the barrels and stuff first. There we- come on. Okay, well, just- there we are. Alright, there we go. Let's hang back here now. Not much else to do here. So good. There we go. Alright. Grab that, throw it there, hop on over, door, something, something. Onto the back right away. Let's try to time this quick. Get it on our first try because my technique is monster. Alright, 2 candles for us to get at. Another little slow weighty thingy. I don't really need to push that box down there. If I'm worried, I can do a magicite stacking thing. And now we wait. Anytime now. There we go. Hop right on off and straight into the thing. Once again, don't have to hop on the block, which for some reason doesn't move when the thing moves. You'd assume it would, but you know, physics doesn't really apply in this game, considering we have people who can double jump into the air like crazy. I prefer going for the flan first. Oh god, I forgot to pull out the wall. Oh, how embarrassing.
Oh, this was going to happen. I knew it was going to happen. No, I've screwed it all up. Okay, well the good news is I can just like go over here. Okay, that's the wrong way. I think over here? Yeah, there you go. And then we can just quickly pull the wall out. So the game doesn't punish you, like, very much, but it's enough to, like, embarrass you for being a fool. So let's just go over here and pull out that wall and do things properly this time, like a fool who didn't do things properly, like pull out a wall. I always forget about the wall sometimes. Oh, annoying. There you go. And I believe we can just walk all the way back now. We should be able to. In here, and yeah, we should be able to. We'll be fine. There we go. Alright, a little bit of a detour, not too bad, though. Well, actually, it's extremely bad. You should actually keep that in mind.
Alright, there you go. Let's try killing that flan now. Now that the wall is gone, and I'm not being a stupid dumbo. There we go. Alright. Take care of the lizard man. Oh, I didn't kill him at once. Darn it, and I got stunned too. You are just trying to make this run terrible, aren't you? I have a pirate eye patch, dude. I have a pirate hat. You can't do this to me. I'm certified in piracy. There we go. Oh, okay, right, you can't pick it. Alright. I assumed that thing would still be able to spawn on your head if you aligned yourself properly. Evidently, not the case. Not too worried about the magic sites I'm using either because, I'm at much lower risk, actually, when I'm doing this, since I don't have to encounter as many fights. So let's just hop on up here. There we go. Skip that last one. There we are. Switch over here, here. Switch over to my raised magic site while we're running down this long corridor, so now I can show this off as well. And as you can see, it takes you to the opposite end, as I said previously. And let's take care of this bat. It's a bit of a shame that I didn't get an increased attack bonus, but I'll take it. I'll also actually grab these healing items just in case because we're right on the doorstep of the bosses now. I don't want to do this again. And I believe after you complete this fight once, you can actually fight any boss you want in any order. So I'll actually be fighting them in the same order once again. Hopefully we'll be able to have a better run of Blue Chaspo compared to last time where everything was messy and terrible. And hopefully we can take care of these bats quickly too. Yeah, get out of here. Screw you. There we go. Alright, do I have enough to max out my Cure Magicite pockets? I do! Fantastic! Once again, being the amazing Let's Player I am, kaboom! All of them are maxed out. No. Alright, let's go. Try this again. Chuck that right there! Hee-haw! Alright, let's go. Skip the enemies again, and yep, all the things are available for us. I believe we want to go to the top one first, and let's prepare by going to our elixirs. Hi, Kuchaspo, ready to get a second beating by a pirate this time? Because I sure am ready to give you one. Oh, I hope I stun you lots and lots. You know what? While I'm doing this, I'm just going to switch to my Blizzard Magicites real quick, because I have a feeling that I want to really just mess him up today. Hopefully I'll be able to just teach him a lesson. Teach this guy a lesson, trying to bully a Selkie. Trying to make it so it seems like Selkies can't beat the game in multiplayer. How dare you? I say, how dare you, sir? Selkies are cool, dang it. We get to wear pirate gear. Oh, I got stunned. Boy, oh boy. Alright. Alright, you know what? Okay, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. That should take you off your spell casting. There we are. Okay, that's just actually hurting quite a bit. So I'm just gonna heal. Get hit, hopefully not. There we go. Back to business. Oh yeah, I should have mentioned, using Blizzard Magic Sites is also effective if you don't have the critical hits. However, another annoying thing is when he keeps doing that. Alright, let's just keep working on him. As you can see how much damage you can do to this guy, he is pretty easy once you get the hang of him. Okay, well he got me now because I can't stun him. Unless I did. That would be nice if I stunned him, but as you can see, much less health than before. So that's great. And we can just keep working on that because I just feel like being a bully today. Cool. Ow, that guy interrupted me. Okay, this is what I was talking about, how things can go badly. Alright, one more hit, there we go. Almost dead, he's gonna respawn his little minions. I'm gonna miss. You can also jump into the air in the attempt to avoid him. And I don't really care too much for attempting to use an elixir, so let's just... get care of him. Take care of him, please. Just run around in circles, really. Alright. Can you die yet? There we go. Well, I got hit. Not exactly the best victory, considering I was flat on my face when it happened, but not too bad, in my opinion. There we go. Got one down. Let's take care of the next guy. Obviously, the next guy's a lot easier, because you know how it is. Hierophant, easy peasy. Keep aiming at his back. That is the wrong Hierophant. I don't want to fight you just yet. Alright, let's go back. There we are. That is not the fight I was looking for, but okay. Yeah, speedrun, right? Isn't that right? Oh god.
How do I forget something like this already? Jeez, I just entered that area. That fight wasn't even that long, it was like 3 minutes. At this rate, this video's gonna be a 2-hour long movie or something. Wow, I don't know what that noise is, I'm sorry. Alright, let's keep working on this guy. Take care of you soon enough. And you're immune too. No, he's beat me to it. Kuchesco is ready with his revenge. At least I didn't use any elixirs. So I can work on him. We can do this. We can beat the exact same boss we just beat twice. Because someone, a certain Let's Player is actually a big fool. Alright, it's okay. I'm not gonna game over now just because I screwed up something. You're gonna die one more time. You know, one more for Kuchesco. I don't appreciate you. You dirtbag. Trying to sell me items and then trying to kill me so you can get the items back and sell them to other adventurers. Despicable. Despicable. Alright. Try this again. Run over to you. Hey, buddy. Oh, I didn't. I missed that a little bit. Alright, let's prepare another one. I'm gonna line up so all three arrows hit him like that. You can actually do quite a bit of damage with that, surprisingly, so that'll be something to keep in mind. I guess Loki's don't really have too much of a benefit. The good thing they have is that they are able to stun quite a bit. Yuke's probably have the worst time with it because of how slow the fight can be. And Kovats have it the easiest, actually, because they can just melee the crap out of him. The bad news is that you have to get close range, which means you have to deal with all three Kuchaskos. It might be easiest to deal with Kuchaskos as a Selkie. I personally don't think so, though. Because, before learning how to do this, before spending that week trying to figure this guy out, I had a very tough time trying to beat him in any way. Because of something like that, that can happen. That, not a fan of that. Alright, let's lure him away. Please don't get hit by a random dark orb thing that you just have.
There we go. Alright. Once again, it's dead. Please, no more. No more. You know, I hate the way they, like, set up the things. Why is the first fight, like, at the very top, and then the second fight to the left? Why can't it just go from like a clockwise or like counterclockwise if you want it? At least that would make sense. Alright, let's fight the Hierophant. Proper this time. Jeez, this video only gets longer and longer. And I'm going back to that store and buying things, by the way. I want as many supplies as I can because we still got plenty to do. Maybe not plenty to do in terms of fighting, but still plenty to do. So I'm not ready for things to just go south for me just yet. And since the next few videos after this one will probably be very short since they're essentially extras displaying a little bit of multiplay, I'll probably just keep the pirate set as my final set. And like maybe I'll like show off the costumes later on or something like that because, oh, I'm about to get chucked over again. Because I like the pirate set. Well, I'd like to give it its fair share of screen time, albeit it's already gotten plenty because we're fighting through this entire area again. With Kuchaskos being fought, what, three times? Yeah, three times total. Well, two times with the pirate suit, so that's pretty good. Once again, you want to smack this guy as many times as you can since it's impossible to avoid that attack. Oh, okay, I just avoided the attack. Alright, well, you learn something new every day. Stay as far away from the center as possible. There you go. And we get a faster fight on this guy at least, which is not too bad. Alright, give me your free stuff. Please don't drop off to the edge. I worked hard for it. Yeah. Look at all this stuff that I don't really need. Ready to get back to this thing? Oh boy, I can still game over on this fight. I hate this fight so much. Alright, let's go. Beat this boss. I could try, but... Listen, This guy's hard. This guy is very hard. Even the charge attack doesn't do that much damage. You can tell. It's half of what Kuchaspo takes. This guy has double of Kuchaspo's health usually. And look at how much defense this guy has too. It's terrible. Everything about this guy is terrible. Can't get supplies very often in the battlefield. There's no full way of recharging all of your supplies when you're playing in multiplayer because you can't leave the place. It's claustrophobic a little bit. He's sitting in the center, so your area effect happens very easily. You have a bunch of annoying crystal minions here, which respawn, of all things. They have to respawn, of course. There's a little knob down there where you can get trapped there and never ever come back out if you have gravity casted on you, because then you can't do anything to jump, and then like they're stacking four spells on you, and then the meteors come in and it's like whoop-de-doopy-doo. I'm just complaining about this boss fight at this point, mainly because I had too many infuriating moments with this fellow right here. Had I not gotten him on my first try in the previous thing, had I not gotten him on my second, I would have probably restarted that recording like the other four. So, I have lots and lots of rage for this guy. Heal, there we go. Alright, let's take this calmly, so to say. Not very calm considering there's a bunch of crystals organizing a giant assault on me. This is payday with crystals, you could say. This is a police assault right here. Do you even know what I'm talking about? I don't know what I'm talking about now. Okay, well, let's just avoid that real quickly. Heal again. That's 7 cure mana sites. If I manage to get through this first phase, it'll be great. I'll be able to use potions for the second phase. Unless I get hit by a laser beam, then I won't have a chance to use anything. But, soon enough. Please stop hitting me with your spells. This is too much. Also, I would recommend you avoid jumping during this fight. Jumps are slow, they're not very beneficial, and you're probably gonna get yourself killed that way. Let's hit that crystal, please. Oh, nope, okay. There you go, now it's gone. Oh, we're so close to the second phase, please. Please. Go away, stupid crystal, stop putting stuff on me. Oh, Lord. Such a hard way of avoiding that stuff. Alright, we're almost there though, we're almost there. Avoid these crystals, gonna hit by gravity, of course I am. Alright, you know what, let's not play it too dangerously here though. Gravity. Okay, one more time. Oh jeez, we're sitting at 3 Kira Magsites, this is... Oh, thank goodness, okay. Okay, this should be a lot easier now. Now that we don't have 3 annoying minions constantly casting stuff on me. And I get a bigger battlefield. Alright, let's get to this. Let's finish this recording. Please, it's been 1:30. The last 30 minutes have been pointless, haven't they? I'm pretty sure they have. There you go, avoid the meteors. Swing back in, do as much damage as I can. Doing great here, lots of damage. Okay, gravity hurts. That's fine though, we're good. I could use the Cure Magicites, but I don't want to risk it. Albeit, it's better to have the Cure Magicites on this fight so you can immediately make sure you get that kill when you have to do a spell ring lock. But still, potions are just enough. Oh god, I don't want that. There we go, managed to jump over that. For a second there, I thought I was still gravitied, so that's bad. You do less damage, you're blinded. And it's a terrible time really, considering he might laser beam you. And you can't know for sure until you've actually been laser beamed. Unless you see it. And you can't see it when you're blind. Do you understand? You understand my gripes with this fight? Ugh. Why do you have 4 wings? You have 6 wings, Ashley, with your little stupid red knobby thingies. What is wrong with you? You are... What has 6 wings? I have no clue what has 6 wings. That is a very specific number. Does anyone need 6 wings? Now, that's a good question, buddy. Is that the reason why you do worse and worse throughout your fight? Because you keep sprouting out wings here and there? Don't need that many, pal. You don't need that many. Considering you're already... Like, you don't have legs to begin with. This guy's basically a bee, isn't he? He has little, like, sharp horny thingies on the top of his head. How often is evil bee moon god? Could it be? It could be. Alright. Almost done with him, halfway through. Please don't laser beam me right now, that's a bad idea. Oh, hey, a laser beam. Okay, back behind you we go. Alrighty, my voice is getting dry.
Oh boy, so what are we going to do for the next video? I reckon the next video will be checking out the castle, which is one of the two big things we can do in multiplay. And then after that, we'll check on the extra dungeon, which a few people have noticed, have told me. Believe me, I know. I'm just slow and lazy on recording. You know, I don't even know if anyone's watching this, but you know what? I'll fight hoping that people do. Alright, let's run away from this guy real quick. Oh, we're sitting near the edge here too. He's right in the center, which once again makes this annoying. The good news is that there's quite a bit of range up top, so you can definitely run towards the north if you ever need to. Just like in real life if you live in America. Actually, running to the north of anything is usually better. Except Korea. Or Vietnam. Don't do that. Well, it depends. Are you okay with communists? Still no North Korea though, that's a bad idea. Alright. Let's not get political on an RPG here about silly people who sound like little children beating up moon gods. Alright. Almost there. As you can see, a lot smoother, getting hit a lot less often. Just as they say. There we go, back to it. Man, this thing is going to be very, very annoying to edit. Alrighty. We're almost there. Yeah, there we go. Got enough attacks here. Got a few crits going on to help me out too. Alright, you are very annoying. Good thing we have lots of potions. And you should be dead. Alright, gotta switch to our magic sites. Get ready. There we are. Right to it. And lock it up again. Oh, and if you screw up, the Hierophant respawns with like either a half bar of health or a full bar of health. So don't do that. That's a bad idea. Yeah, I don't really care. Fantastic. Give me my stuff. Done with this nonsense. I've been in the sky twice. I'm gonna go back to town, buy a few things, have a few drinks, and call it a day. There we go. Don't need to see the credits, buddy. Nope. Just, yep, there we go. Alright, through we go. Wow. We finally did it. Twice. Just because. Amazing. Alrighty. Let's just hop in here. What do we have? Grab that. And grab these, and we are actually really low on money once again. I can sell some things though. We got plenty of supplies from fighting the same final bosses two times with Kuchaspo on a 3. More potion slots, which is always nice because I'm okay with potions, and ethers, which we've been lacking on quite a bit. There we are. Let's go over here, Kuchaspo. What do you sell right now? Yeah, just pretend that didn't happen. I'm basically beating an old man at this point, and I'm okay with it because I don't like this one. This one specifically, I don't like you at all. Alright. Refined Ruby, we've been waiting for these. There we go. Refined Amethyst, there we go. We can get Raz. Yeah, this is the loot I was looking for. Come on. Oh, okay. Oh, there's the Amethyst. Okay, there we are. That's pretty good. Buy him. You know, I don't even know why we're buying these. We don't really need them anymore. There we go. That is that. We have beaten the final boss 2 times. Thank you for watching this episode of Ring of Fates. In the next one, we'll go check on those screams in the castle. And in the meantime, I'll be editing an hour, 34 minute long video. Take care, everyone.
You are a pirate!
You're our favorite indeed! Being a pirate is our right to be! Do what you want, cause a pirate